Hello dear students, in this video we will solve this question: which compound contains both ionic and covalent bonds? So to solve this question we have to discuss the structure of these compounds. First one is magnesium oxide. So magnesium atomic number is 12, configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p, 6, 3s2. So there are two electrons in the third shell. So according to the octet rule, there should be 8 electrons. But it is very difficult to gain 6 electrons. But it is easy for it to lose these two electrons. So on losing it, these two electrons, there will be two positive charge. And similarly, oxygen. It has configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. So it can easily gain 2 electrons to complete its octet, because there are total 6 valence electrons. So on gaining 2 electrons, there will be 2 negative charge. So there are ionic interactions, or we can say ionic bonding between these ions. So here is ionic bonding, and next is CH2 Cl2, and configuration of carbon is 2s2 2p2, right? So there are 4 electrons in the valence shell, 4 electrons in the valence shell, and hydrogen has one electron of hydrogen, so now duplet state is followed. Duplet state is here by sharing one electron with carbon, and for hydrogen, but for carbon there should be 8 electrons. Now 2 electrons are already involved in covalent bonding with 2 hydrogen atoms. Then configuration of chlorine is 3s2 3p5. So there are 7 electrons in the valence shell of the chlorine. So if it gain 1 electron, then its octet will be complete. So both chlorine atoms will share one electron with the carbon. So 2 single bonds with 2 chlorine atoms. So all are the covalent bonds. So here covalent bonding is involved in the CH2Cl2. Similarly, CH3COH. Here also I'll just draw the structure. There is single bond between the carbon and 3 hydrogens, single bond with the another carbon, double bond with the oxygen, single bond with the oxygen, and the single bond of oxygen with the hydrogen. So here all are the covalent bonds in the CH3COH. Now next is NaOH, sodium hydroxide. Firstly, let's see the hydroxide structure. Oxygen has 2s2, 2p4. So 6 electrons are here, and it shares one electron with the hydrogen. And now hydrogen has 2 electrons. Its duplet rule is followed. Now there is one more electron. So now there are total 7 electrons around the oxygen. If it gains one more electron, then its octet is followed. So hydroxide has one negative charge, and sodium has one positive charge, and there is ionic bonding between the sodium ion and the hydroxide ion, and here covalent bond is there. So both covalent and ionic bonds are there in NaOH. So D option will be the right answer.